Blackstone presents Valley of Shadows, a novel by Rudy Ruiz. This book is read by Gary Tiedemann. For Heather, Paloma, Isabella, and Lorenzo. Prologue. Frankie Tolbert pouted at the dinner table, staring down at his half-eaten beef and potato stew. Tiny carrots floated in brown gravy, like miniature orange islands. He imagined himself marooned on one, all alone. His checkered napkin was stuffed into his collar to shield his white t-shirt and denim overalls from the sauce. Mother forced him to put it there, as if he were still a little kid. He despised having to stay behind with her and his little sisters while his father and older brother tended to men's business. It wasn't often that someone knocked at the door in the middle of dinner after the sun had set and dusk had fallen. He figured something exciting must be going on, and he wanted to be a part of it. After all, he had just turned 10. He was only 3 years younger than his older brother. Why did Johnny get to have all the fun? Would he always be left behind with the women? He brooded as his mom glanced anxiously out the window. "Y'all keep eating. Don't let your food get cold," she said. His sisters, Abigail and Beatrice, raised their forks in unison, their golden curls bouncing up and down as they bobbed their heads. "Yes, ma'am," they chimed. How was it fair for him to be treated the same as an 8-year-old and a 6-year-old? They were practically babies, and girls to boot. He stared longingly at the front door. His father had left it slightly ajar, and the buzzing of cicadas drifted in with the evening breeze. They sounded like a never-ending chorus of rattlesnakes to Frankie. Rattlesnakes were dangerous, like the night itself. That's why his dad had charged him with staying with the women. When his dad and older brother weren't around, it was his job to protect them. He tried to reconcile his symbolic position with his authentic desire to know what was happening out back in the barn, where the men had circled moments earlier. His mother's eyes flicked from the window to the front of the house. Then, the familiar-faced man reappeared in the crack between the door and the frame. He nudged the door slightly with his boot and called out to them in the dining room.
"Mrs. Tolbert, your husband says y'all should come on back and see this too. It's quite fascinating."
Abigail and Beatrice wiggled with excitement in their pink and white gingham frocks. Frankie yanked his bib off, jumped to his feet, and was at the door in a flash. Their mother brought up the rear as the four of them followed the tall man, who sauntered slowly toward the closed barn door. It was dark outside. The clearing between the farmhouse and the barn barely lit by the glow of the oil lanterns inside the house spilling faintly onto the ground. Up in one of the trees, an owl hooted. The night was otherwise eerily quiet. When they reached the barn, the heavy door groaned on its rusted hinges as the man pulled it open, motioning for them to enter first. It was pitch black inside, and when he closed the door behind them, they couldn't see a thing. For the first time that night, Frankie was suddenly not frustrated or excited. He was afraid. He could hear his heart thumping fast in his chest. In the dark, he reached for his mother's hand, but instead found Abigail's, the elder of his two sisters.
"Mom,"
the girls whimpered. Frankie heard the sound of a match being struck against a rough surface. A single flame illuminated a strange shape looming at the back of the barn. Feathery protrusions bristled out from its sides, like spikes, and it was crowned by a wild mane. Was it a man or an animal, or was it something else altogether?
"What's going on?"
Frankie's mom asked, her voice quivering.
"John?"
She called his father's name. But there was no response. A second match was struck, and another lantern lit by a man Frankie did not recognize. He had gray hair and looked distinguished, dressed in a fancy suit. As the meager light diffused through the barn, Frankie's eyes adjusted to his surroundings. Then he saw his father lying in the straw, his shirt covered in blood. His brother Johnny was not far, also on the ground.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.